Welcome to this brief guide on how to make and use checkboxes in Excel. Using Excel for tracking things like task completion or similar has been somewhat difficult and time-consuming, especially when something like a simple checkbox could do the trick easily enough. Today, we're going to check out some brand new functionality in Microsoft 365 that makes this a thing of the past, and then I'll walk through how to get a similar outcome for those without a Microsoft 365 subscription. Here I have an Excel spreadsheet for my roll call. I am using it to track the attendance of all of my students here. I plan to use these cells in the table to track the attendance and then calculate their weekly attendance percentage in the column at the end here. Excel has made this significantly easier recently with the addition of checkboxes in Microsoft 365. I select all of the cells where I want to put a checkbox and then head to the Insert tab in the ribbon. And about two-thirds of the way across, we find a new option for inserting a checkbox. Selecting this will embed a checkbox into our selected cells. And by selecting one of these cells, we can see in the formula bar that it is showing a state of false because it is unticked. Ticking the checkbox will change its state over to true. This is a property that we are going to make use of in our formulas. I'll select the first cell in the last column and then click on the function button. We could just type in the formula, but I am using this to show a couple of things. In the pop-up that we see here, we want to find the COUNTIF formula. If you don't see it in the bottom box, just type it into the top box to search for it. Now we need to configure our COUNTIF formula by firstly selecting the range that we want to look at. We can just click and drag across the cells in the top row here to select them as our range. And we can see that the current range has results of true and false as per our checkboxes. The criteria that we need to count then is the number of true cells. In that case, we type true into the criteria field and select OK. We see the count of 2 in the cell at the moment, and unticking one of the cells changes it in real time to 1. But this isn't the percentage that we are trying to get, so we need to modify our formula a little to get what we need. To find the percentage, we are going to divide our COUNTIF formula by the number of cells in the range. We will use the COUNTA formula for this, which counts the number of cells in a range with data in them. We could have just typed 5 here, but the formula is a way to do this with any number of cells you might have. We now have the answer we seek, and we can use flash fill to propagate this to all the cells below. And while they are selected, we can head to the Home tab in the ribbon and change the cell format over to a percentage. And we can see that they are all updated in real time as we fill in some of the checkboxes. Let's take it a little bit further and make these percentages a little more visual. We can do this by using the conditional formatting option and selecting the data bars option. But this doesn't quite look right as the 60% option is completely full. We need to customize our formatting rule in order to correct this. We do this via the Manage Rules option. We select the Edit Rule option for our selected rule, and we see the reason for the error is the automatic options here. And so we will change these both over to numbers. We want the minimum to be 0 and the maximum to be 100%. Select OK and then select Apply to update our table. And now our conditional formatting is working as expected and giving us a visual indication of each student's attendance. But what if you don't have Microsoft 365 and therefore don't have access to this new feature? Well, luckily, I have a second copy of this table here to show you an alternative you can use instead. For this, we will be using data validation and conditional formatting. Select the cells which we previously put checkboxes into, and then head to the Data tab in the ribbon. We then move over to the Data Tools area and select the Data Validation option. In the pop-up window, we need to configure our validation criteria. And there are a handful of options that we can choose from. For this, we are going to use whole numbers with a minimum option of 0 and a maximum of 1. This gives us only two states to use, just like a checkbox. While we are here, we can use the Input Message tab to provide the user with a tip to help them know what to enter into the cells. I will enter 1 for present and 0 for absent. Now when any cell is selected, the user will see this pop-up to help them out. But we aren't done just yet. Next, we will select all of the cells again, head to the Home tab in the ribbon, and open the conditional formatting options. This time, we want to choose an icon set that has symbols like the tick and cross. We don't need to modify this rule for our purposes, but I will open this rule to explain why it works. The tick is shown when the value is above 67%, which the answer of 1 definitely will be, and the cross is shown if the value is below 33%, which the 0 is. The only thing we may want to do here is select the option to show icon only, which will hide the number being input and help keep our table looking tidy. Entering a 1 into a cell now results in a green tick, and a 0 results in a red cross. Now we just need to sort out the formula for our percentage column at the end. We are going to start with the same COUNTIF formula that we used on the previous sheet. But when we select our initial range, you will see that the values we see are different. This means we need to use 1 as our criteria here. This gives us our count, but we still need to get a percentage by dividing by the COUNTA formula. Whilst this looks like what we need, we have a small problem that becomes evident when we fill this formula down. The COUNTA formula counts the number of cells that are not empty in a range. This is fine in our top row as every cell is filled, but this isn't the case with the rest of our table. We fix this by making a small change to our formula. We will instead divide by the sum of both the COUNTA and COUNTBLANK formulas. This accounts for both cells that are filled and cells that are empty. The reason we require this COUNTBLANK component to our formula here, unlike with our checkboxes, is that our checkboxes were automatically assigned a state of false when they were originally entered in. In our case here, our cells are empty until we enter either a 1 or a 0. Filling this formula down shows that we have the right formula now, and we can see that our percentages all update in real time as we fill in the cells of our table, just like we saw with our checkbox option. And that is the brand new checkbox feature in Excel for Microsoft 365, and an alternative option for those without. I hope you found this guide extremely valuable and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.